So this is my introduction. We are not yet on the air, okay? So it's still not yet there. Any questions so far towards that, you know, making the video and being part of this process? Any questions? No questions? Okay, I hope you will start to have that good communication. I hope I didn't scare you. I hope I didn't scare myself. But we will get more comfortable through the process. Okay, so, yeah, I have to use to the, well, I'm joking now, I'm still not yet on the air, I'm joking too, because here is the camera, here is this, and I have to admit, I was not in the classroom and, you know, having and taking the video, so maybe I will act a little bit weird today, so I apologize for that, but I will start to be comfortable also through the time. Okay, so let's begin our class, PubHlth1. I would like to welcome all of you here to the PubHlth class, which is the introduction to PubHlth or the principles of PubHlth. Before we will completely start, I have a few questions. I would like to know how many of you are here in PubHlth major. Oh, it's amazing. Okay, some of you are even showing two hands. So it means what? You are PubHlth science, PubHlth policy, or just being excited to be in PubHlth. That's amazing. Okay. How many of you are from the biology science, biology major? Some of you. Okay, this is great. So that will be also good that you will add a little bit of the flavor of PubHlth to your biology background. How many of you are here from social sciences, social science? Okay, some of you, oh, be proud of that too. Also, you are scared, like everybody PubHlth, I'm just one from social sciences. Okay, how many of you are of social ecology? Okay, how many of you are mechanical engineering or any engineering? Oh, okay, thank you so much. I know it's, you are surprising, like, well, how come, but we need to have engineers in PubHlth, and you will learn that later when we will be talking about environmental health. How many of you are here from business? Nobody in business. We also need to have business people connected with PubHlth because this is something that we also need to have. How many of you are from journalism? Nobody? Okay, we also need, or some hands are showing a little bit, but it's also very important because we need, as a, you as a future journalist will write, you know, about PubHlth. How many of you are here from psychology and behavioral science? Nobody here. From mathematics, computer science, okay, dancing, art. Well, you are laughing, but it's also very important because, you know, it's, you also, from the PubHlth perspectives, maybe some of you will be in my alternative and complementary medicine class, we talk about therapies through music, therapies through dancing, for the improving the health of the public. So we also need to have dancers with touch a little bit of PubHlth and maybe to do that as a profession for the therapy. Is here any major that I didn't mention and you are in that major? Yeah.
Nursing.
Oh, nursing. Oh, how could I forget? Nursing so close to PubHlth. Welcome here. So so that's something that also we are working very, very close, nursing science and PubHlth. Actually, by the way, also students from nursing and PubHlth program, they are part of the free clinic. So they are doing the education and helping the public with improving the quality of their lives and of their health. Any additional major that I again didn't mention that? Okay, so we covered all of that major, so I have a little bit profile to see that from what type of majors you are here. Okay, so now let's start with the class website. So I hope everybody, did any of you already went through the EEE? To check a little bit things, yeah, okay. Usually every because our class is always on Tuesdays and Thursdays. So before every Tuesday, I will send also your email letting you know, yes, please check your class website, all the PowerPoints and everything, all the chapters are prepared and they are there for the next following week. So please always check the messages from me. I also, on the class website, open the message board. One portion of the message board, it's called like PubHlth forum. So if you have any questions, I notice that was quite practical when I was teaching the online classes to have the forum, to have the communication between instructors and teaching assistant with the students, or actually the students between themselves. Because in case you have some questions, you can post it there. And maybe some of you already know the answer. So you can, you know, put your answer there, or we will check I will check that, and with teaching assistant also like once a day, so in case there are additional questions, so we can respond to you. Of course, you are welcome to use email, but please use also this section forum on the message board, because you know that questions, they are there and answers are there. And maybe you are in the middle of the night and preparing for your paper, and you know that yes, even if I will send email to the instructor, I will not get response, but I will check the forum. Maybe somebody already asked about that and the answer is there. Okay, so use that for these purposes. I'm actually starting to use that the first time. So it looks like your class is a little bit like experimental in all of that way, but it's enhancing. It's will be much better. So that's very important. As you know, we have this class here in this classroom. I would like a little bit introduce myself also, and as you can see, my name is Zuzana Big, and I will ask you question. What do you think, from which country I'm coming? And well, only people that they don't know me. I know that one person knows me here, because when we travel to Chile, actually, from Chile, summer travel program. So you are not part of that process. But so can you guess from which country I'm coming, or my accent can be connected from, with which country? Yeah. Very close, but not completely. Yeah.
Is it Russian?
Slavic background, but not completely. Yeah.
Switzerland?
Oh, I wish. I love Switzerland. Somebody sensing that I am from Switzerland. That sounds good, but no. Yeah.
Romania?
Close, a little bit, but not completely. I'm telling close because it's like the geographical area, not like with the background of that culture of the language, but closer to that geographical area. Yeah.
Austria.
It was one time historically like Hungarian, Hungarian and Austrian Imperium, but it's 100 years now. It's not, but it was part of that country from which I'm coming. Was part of that, but very close, but not. Yeah. The Slavic background, yes, but not the country. So okay, I will start now. Like, this is location historically. There is location. There is the Slavic background. Yeah. Still Slavic background. Well, no, Lithuania is actually another. It's Ugrofin. So Lithuanian. I think it's Ukraine. It's like Slavic. Lithuanian. It's Ugrofin. So it's different. Yeah.
Czech Republic?
Yeah, how did you know?
Czech Republic friend.
What is that?
I have a friend from the Czech Republic.
So you recognize the accent? Yeah?
No, I just guess for him.
Just guessing, okay. Okay, yeah, so let's give her applause. Yeah, I am originally from Czech Republic. So thank you so much for all that guessing. So I was like, wow, I'm from that country. I can be from that country. So it's like, entertaining. But yes, I'm from the Czech Republic. So unfortunately, you have to suffer to listen to my accent for 10 weeks. Okay, so I apologize for that. I know it could be a little bit hard in the beginning, but after again 10 weeks, you will understand everything what I'm talking about, all my accent and everything, so it will be no problem for you. Now, two titles, what I have here. is one title, DRPH, Instructor of Public Health. So this is, I received this degree from Loma Linda University, and it was my expertise, it's in lifestyle medicine. So you will probably notice that I will add a little bit additional thing about the lifestyle medicine to your chapters, and additional things like supplements that they are not always in your textbook. Completely my narrow part of the expertise in lifestyle medicine, that was the headaches and migraines. How many of you are suffering or you know somebody that has problems with migraines and headaches? Okay, oh, many of you, okay. So that will be almost guarantee after you will finish that 10 weeks in the course in Public Health. That will be possible. I'm not telling, eliminating or curing. I'm just telling there will be possible maybe 70% to decrease the risk of the occurrence of the headache or migraine. And as you notice, I was also politically correct how I am using my words. So in Public Health, we are not using the words curing because it's not associated with Public Health. We are always using the words to decrease the risk of occurrence or decrease risk of symptoms. So this is something what you already learn from this when I talk about the headaches. So that will be also one part about the headaches when we will have the section about nutrition. So I will be sharing with you the theoretical model, like how you can decrease the risk of occurrence of the headaches. So it's almost guaranteed that, because my study was showing that 70% was possible to decrease headache occurrence, frequency, intensity. So some of this you will learn through this class. And of course, headaches, it's very annoying and it's public health problem. So that here you will be and learning something about prevention of headaches. So that was my part connected with Loma Linda University. And now again, I will ask you the question, what do you think it's the MUDR? Don't tell me it's like some of my classmates at Loma Linda, they told me, oh, you are the math doctor. And I don't know. But so any guessing? It's on the international level. The degree I didn't get in US, it was outside US, it was in Europe, actually in Czech Republic. Okay, so no guessing? Okay, so the MUD, well, I'm not taking that person, it's only one that she was traveling with me in summer travel program in Chile last year. So the MUDR, it's the abbreviation, is the Medicine Universitas Doctor. So I finished medical school in Czech Republic, okay, so it's like MD here in United States. Why I'm talking about that also and emphasizing that? Because when I was studying at medical school, I somehow always were curious, I was very, very curious, like how we can prevent the disease. So, you know, it's long time ago when I actually graduated from medical school, that was back 1980. Many of you were not yet in this world, 1980. I graduated from medical school and I always had desire to find out how we can prevent the disease, what we can do with primary, secondary, tertiary prevention. I didn't know in that time that meanings, all of them, but I was thinking like, what can I do if the patient is coming at this moment and we are giving and prescribing the medication, and after a couple months the patient is coming again with same symptoms or a little bit different symptoms, it's still not completely decrease the symptomatology of that disease, and is it possible that lifestyle, the behavioral, the nutrition, the physical activity, if the person is doing or not, or the stress, or sleeping enough of hours, is it possible that that can influence the outcome of the disease? And you know, back 1980, and especially in Europe, in Czech Republic in that time, because it was the communist system, nobody was talking about that. It didn't exist. If we use the public health, it was much more connected with hygiene, preventative, some infectious diseases, or ergonomics, but nobody was thinking like, wow, how we can really prevent disease on individual level and improving the quality of life for the public. So I was very curious about that. When I finished medical school, I was in the neuroscience or neurology, therefore it was the connection later with the headaches and migraines. And so I usually call that as a destiny to coming to United States, because when I come to United States, I have two pathways in front of me, or two choices. One choice was like to go and have and continue in the medical degree and just, you know, going through this specific residency program and doing the prescription of medication, or to do something using the background and do something for the preventative measures. And again, because it was my interest when I was in medical school, I decided to go for that direction. So therefore I end up, you know, at Loma Linda University. I think also what was the motivation, another motivation when I was at medical school to go for the preventative measures, because, you know, it was quite surprising. All medical students there during that time, they were smoking. Many of them were smoking and drinking coffee. And if we went with our professors to the hospital and we were checking the patients, so after 1 hour there was the break, and they called it like, not completely as a coffee break, but it was the break that everybody sit together and they were smoking. I didn't smoke, so I was suffering. I was thinking, well, if I don't smoke, I still have to work. I cannot rest based on that approaches from the community. So I was actually motivated in the way also, because I was thinking, well, I have the right to rest also and not, you know, be excluded because I am not, you know, drinking coffee too much. I'm not smoking. So it means that I don't have the right to have the, you know, to break and to sit and just to talk. So that, you know, imagine that was quite interesting, that coming to the physician office and the physician was smoking. So back 1980, that was quite common. So it's now it's almost like quite paradoxical. How come? What the people didn't know that could have, that could be problem, you know, with the smoking. Yes, they knew, but somehow the medical community, or especially like they were thinking, well, we can take care of ourselves. Well, they didn't know, actually, it was some kind of misleading in that way. So this is a little bit my background. So now you know. I would like also, we have excellent. I talk already with your teaching assistant, and I know she will be great. And so I would like to introduce to you Jamie, is that right? So let's do nice applause for her. And she will tell you a few things about her.
Hello everyone, my name is Jamie Allgood, not God, not all God. There's another O in there.
Okay, I'm sorry.
It's okay, I just, I did my undergraduate work at UCLA, and I also did a master's there in women's studies, and my concentration was maternal and child health, and I did most of my focus work in the graduate school of public health there. And while I was there, I started two studies, one on HIV and one on gestational diabetes. And I stayed on after graduation and worked at the Center for AIDS Research and Education, and also in the Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology for about 4 or 5 years. And then I took a break, and I was an over-the-road truck driver for 5 more years, at which point I decided I wanted to come back to school, and I'm doing a PhD in public health, and my focus now is environmental health, and my research is on green chemistry. And if any of you would like to talk to me about any of that, I please do so, and I look forward to working with you all this quarter.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so now you know a little bit that about me and about the teaching assistant. I also would like to let you know, please check, there will be a lot of links also connected with this class. And we will, some of the links, we will open that and go through them in the class. Some of them I will recommend you to open and just to do on your own. Now we are coming to the syllabus. Usually the first day of the class I concentrate on the syllabus, and maybe we will go through the first chapter, but I recognize that it's quite important to go through the syllabus. I know that some of you already check the syllabus, so this is actually the picture of the textbook that you need to have that. So this is the basic that we will be using, and you know, in this class. You have also additional one that you will be much more responsible on your own. Why is that? Because this is the description of the jobs in public health. There will be not many questions on the midterm or final exam. Usually there will be like two or three questions. I got the feedback from alumni from this, not just PubHlth1 class, but also from PubHlth on its own, the bachelor degree, that when they were looking for the job, so they suddenly realized, wow, I remember I was using this textbook during the PubHlth1, completely the first time when I started to study PubHlth, because there are, there is the information about, for example, a nurse connected with PubHlth or PubHlth veterinarians. So there are many different jobs that they are outside in the world, they are connected with PubHlth. It's also description of course about the salary, but also resume, what is, there is the description of the work that the person in that field will be doing, and also what is except what is what they try when you are applying for that work, what they are expecting from you to know. So it's quite interesting to go through that. But again, so it will be your own responsibility. So for example, if there will be the midterm test question, the question will be like, what is the function or what is the work of PubHlth Educator 1 or PubHlth Educator 2? So that you know a little bit like what are the responsibilities. So you have a little bit some kind of basic information. I also added the PowerPoint slides. So you will have PowerPoint slides reading on your own with this textbook. Here is the information about the office hours. So I will have that Friday from 11:30 to 3 p.m., so actually tomorrow also. The office hours of teaching assistant will be added on the class website. And I found out on the class website there is the section that is called chat. I didn't know. So we can use maybe once a week, I will just send information to the class, yes, now for that 1 hour I am open, or teaching assistant is open for the chat, so you can send whatever information. Sometimes during the online class when I'm teaching that, I'm using the Skype, so you can use the Skype too, but I'm afraid that I will be just sitting and answering Skype and everything, so I probably cannot do that completely, but eventually if I will get on the Skype or on the chat, so we can do the communication. So this is the basic of the syllabus. Now here you can get, how many of you have already textbooks? Many of you? Yeah, okay. What are the requirements for the class? It's the research paper, presentation, midterm, and final exam. You are probably thinking like, oh, what about the presentation? Well, again, remember you are in the PubHlth field. It's very important that you are, you know, expressing the information to the public by talking. You will do probably, some of you will be doing, you know, education, PubHlth promotion. So public actually talking and speaking, it's very, very important. And I would like that you do that in that, you know, entertainment way, or also in the way that you will really enjoy that. And you will not have any fear of the public speaking. Usually I do the presentations in all my PubHlth classes. So usually the alumni from my old PubHlth classes, they are giving me feedback, well, now we really enjoy to have the public speech. Okay. So for all of this, you will have also a rubric at the end of the syllabus. Here in the red color, you have information that they are the due dates. So even if I really recommend to print probably the syllabus. I know it's a little bit more pages, it's probably 15 pages, but this is something that you will find all answers in the syllabus. I know that syllabus could be like one page or two page, and maybe you have that experience with other professors to have that like that, but then probably you'll have so many questions all the time. So the syllabus actually, it's based on the experience what I have with the students asking all the questions, so I try somehow to put that answers already in your syllabus. So I even try for you to arrange that what's happening for you week 7, week 5, 8, week 6, and week 11. So now you are thinking, oh, until the week 5, I can just sleep. Please don't sleep. It's very important because you have to prepare. I am giving you a little bit time, especially like completely in the beginning, the first few weeks, because I know that you need to find the orientation in the class a little bit, asking first questions, getting information for the research paper and everything. But when you will have the presentations in the group, you already start to work on that as soon as possible. So here is also the grading system. I am not doing the scale. I am doing like everybody is responsible for its own points or the percentage. The reason is because you have the presentations. And because you have presentations, you are working as a public health team together. So if I will do some kind of competitive things on scale, then you will be not sharing the information together and you will be not able to work as a public health team together. The word public health team is crucial for public health profession. I know it's probably completely different from all the experience that you have in other classes, or maybe some of you are just coming from the high school and and you are freshmen here. So that's completely new for you now, like, wow, this is like public health team. But remember, and if you see some kind of situations that they are happening on the environmental health or natural disasters, if it's not working team together in public health, then it's really additional, that situation is happening on its own if we already have the natural disasters. And you can check that and compare with Hurricane Katrina and all the things. So you need to find out and you need to learn how is responsibly and fairly to work in the public health team. And so I will be trying to, to show you that part. So also please remember that I put there points, but don't do just a regular summation of the points, because this is not representation of your grade. You have to, each of that points, you have to translate in percentage. It's the value. So you have research paper, you can see possible 0.75, but it's 15% of your grade. So be aware about that. I always mention it in the beginning, and it's happening many times at the end of the 10 weeks course, that students are doing just summation. Thus, it's much better actually for the students to have the value, the percentage. And so it means that, because otherwise you would be thinking, oh, these 75%, 75 points is the same like that 75 points. It's not, it's a different value. So be aware about that, okay? I will also give extra credit. I have to think about that. So you will probably, this will be updated on your class website probably week 2 or week 3. So you will have time to do any time, the extra credit because the deadline will be the week 10. So it's usually the last day of the class. And because you are in public health class doing the preventative things, you can do, even if you think like, oh, maybe I don't need to have extra grade, you never know. So I hope many of you will do the preventative things. And if in the first few weeks you are free, you will be able to do the extra credit. Usually the extra credit is to attend any of seminars from public health or also videos that they are also already on our Department of Population Health and Disease Prevention website. So you will be able to listen to the video and write a summary. So usually there are some kind of examples like that, but I will post that during the week too. If your work is late, so that will be -1 point for each day, okay? So that's the information. Another very important thing is you will be, when you submit your research paper, the research paper will be submitted to Digital Dropbox and also to Turnitin. Why it's important to do the Turnitin? Because you have to understand that your work needs to be completely creative work, your own work. Sometimes if students are not completely sure how this works, even if you put the quotation marks, but sometimes I have experience with the students that half of the paper was quotation marks. Okay, so I know you're laughing now, but I'm always surprised that when it comes really to the research paper, suddenly half of this is quotation mark, and students is really strongly telling me, well, I knew about that and I did it because I liked it, it was perfectly written, I couldn't write that better, so I did the quotation mark. I really acknowledge the author. But, you know, that it's not possibly. Imagine that you will do research and you will send your research paper to a specific scholar journal, and now there will be all the quotations. So of course the other researchers that they wrote that, they are always checking the topics, and if they see like, wow, somebody is using, even you will give the acknowledge that, but you are using exactly the sentence, they will be quite upset, because maybe they spent day and night, you know, to creating the words and creating the sentences, and now even if they get the acknowledge, it's the exactly their sentence. So if you are using the citations and acknowledging the author, we are using if there is some important information, if there are statistics or something that is quite new that you learn, and based on this you are writing your paper, then you are acknowledging that, but even this part, you are creating the sentences, okay? So be sure about that. Another thing I wanted to share with you, sometimes students were thinking, okay, I call it like fishing. So they take one sentence from, they have maybe 10, 15, maybe 20 articles, and taking one sentence from each of that paper, okay? And then put everything, all the sentences, fit that together to their paper, okay? But I can see that, it's the colorful. I can see like 1% there, 1% there, 1% there. So eventually if you put it together, there is like 20%. It's you know, from outside, it's not the creative thing of that student, and you will see like exactly, because I can see like blue color, the whole sentence was taken from there and there, another red color, this sentence exactly. So I was just laughing about that, and I was thinking, well, this is really fishing, you know, for that. So be aware, I can see all the colors there. I mean, you will be surprised. I was sometimes thinking that I would like to show you in that colors, but I cannot hide the name, you know, of the authors of that article, so it's not possible to show that to you, but I think you can maybe have access on your own to turn it in, but so you can see that different colors. Another thing is, I have sometimes experienced with students that I check that and it's written like, oh, 70%, and there is written like other student work. So I check that, and it's the same student, but the student was using that paper, that topic to other class. And the student is telling me, oh, it's my creative work from other class. And I thought, well, it's not possible, you can't do that. And student is challenging me and telling, oh, I love the topic, what can I do? I just love the topic, so I wanted to have the same, you know, paper. So then you don't need to take other classes, and it's not possible to do that, you know, like that. So be aware about that too. So if you have, and you have some topic, and maybe you use that in your anthropology class or writing class, and you like the topic, it's great if you have the topic, but you have to do the from the different perspectives. You cannot use, you know, the same one for other class. And it's, if I talk about that, you know, I'm trying to explain to the students to prevent being embarrassed when you are in the real field and really working as a public health provider. Because imagine that something like this you will send to the scholar journal. It's not possible that there will be one article the same published in two or three scholar journals. Then we don't need to have so many scholar journals. So be aware about that. I always try to explain that, and I'm, you know, sometimes surprised that even I explain everything, I'm still getting some kind of responses. It's not always, but sometimes. So be aware about that, and trust yourself that even if you think like, well, this was perfectly written, I cannot write it better, yes, you can. You can write it much better than somebody wrote it there, because, you know, you have more new innovative things. Sometimes I let students to know, well, if you are not so sure in the beginning how to write that, try to read these different articles and think like, if somebody will be sitting in front of you, how you will be talking about it, how you will express yourself, or to do recording your thoughts and based on this, start to do the writing, okay? So you can always please believe in yourself, trust yourself that you can do it much better than somebody, you know, in other articles the person did, okay? So this is very, I put it in the red color, so be aware about this. In case also you need to do, you know, you need some help with the writing, there are links that you can get also help, so they will be, you know, the tutoring through the writing. If you have any, you know, questions, please come to us also, to me or teaching assistant, we'll be very happy to help you also. Literature, where you can find literature for your research papers, this is through the library. If you click on that, you have also specific section. Some of you were actually on Monday on the welcoming. How many of you were on the welcoming for public health majors? Okay, do you remember you have the presentation from the librarian? So that was very useful. Some of you, if you were not there, click also on that link and or maybe make the appointment and go and talk with the librarian. We have the specific section on public health, so all the articles and everything will be helpful to you. Okay, so here is additional, there are additional website. There will be more additional website during the process through the class. This is the course schedule. So you will know what's happening each of the week. As you can see, it's quite a little bit tricky. Do we have the first week or not yet? So it looks like partial, yes. So you will see what's happening in each of that week and what kind of topic we will be covering. So that's your schedule here. We will be also going through video clips. We will have the guest speakers. We will be also having the public health news, so all that information you will go through the class. you have also here due when it's red color, so please stop and see what information is there. Okay, you will have the midterm. And there is the research paper, another presentation, and then you will have final exam. I would like a little bit concentrate also on some citations or proverbs, staying healthy. So if you read some of them and look on them, like the first one, it was anonymous, eat what you want to eat after you eat what you should eat. You think it's true? So just the basic, you know, proverb like that, if public will be following that, we probably will decrease, you know, the problem with obesity and diabetes. So I wish, I would like to know who who said that back 1918, so almost soon it will be 100 years back. Or other from Hippocrates, the food shall be the medicine. How many of you were thinking when you had the breakfast that what you are eating is the medicine that you are putting in your body? And thinking like, wow, this what I'm eating will decrease my cholesterol level, this what I'm eating will improve my blood pressure, this what I'm eating will increase my cognitive part, and I will be just so alert and listening and absorbing everything in the class. How many of you were thinking in that way? So I hope, oh, some of you, that's good that we have like pioneers. So it is almost guaranteed after you will finish this class that many of you will be thinking in that way. And your other, you know, friends or classmates will be thinking like, what are you doing? Why are you thinking what you are putting on your plate? Eat what you want to eat. And you tell like, well, I will eat what I want to eat, but after, you know, I will eat what I should eat. Or thinking like, well, here are the antioxidants, anti-inflammatory type of the food, fruits, vegetables, and grains, and beans. And so I need to have these antioxidants to be really alert, you know, in my classes. What do you think about Thomas Jefferson? So, how many of you, based on the Thomas Jefferson, how many of you are complaining that my next class is quite far, the location from this class? How many of you need to, you know, the other class is so far from this class? How many of you need to run? Okay. Okay, so you are fortunate, okay? You are fortunate because it's amazing. You will be doing some physical activity. you have to run. So enjoy that, be happy about that, okay? So some of you that you have the, you know, moving just from this classroom to another classroom, you are not doing any physical activity. So all of you that you were upset and thinking before, oh, I have to run on other, you know, corner of the campus, be, you know, grateful and think like, well, this was done in that way that I really can do some physical activity. So enjoy that, okay? So what do you think about William Shakespeare? So do you think, do you agree with William Shakespeare? Is it true? So think about that sometimes, like how much time you are just spending and debating and doing the assumption, and then it's off on its own. So how many of the hours you are also losing because of that? So that also, it's very important and some part of the stress management we will have in the class. And last here is the proverb that is actually accepted by Public Health Association here. Students accepted that. And if you look on that, what do you think? Do you think also it's very important, that one? And it's something like, you know, in the short version, I can mention like, well, in a healthy body, that is the healthy mind. So I would like also, and I hope after you finish this class, that you will be aware in order to have A plus or A or, you know, the A minus, the greatest grades in the class, it's connected not only how many hours you are just studying and studying and studying, but also how you are taking care of your body. Do you have enough of fresh air? Do you have, you know, nutritious food with high level of antioxidants helping you to that your mind will be working in the proper way? Do you do really stress management? Because it's not just if I will be sitting 10 hours and studying, maybe you are sitting, but maybe you are not studying efficiently. If you are taking care of your body and you will have your body healthy, then maybe you need less amount of the time to understand that topic in your class. And you will be able to do all of that things, to be on the fresh air and having and buying the, you know, fresh fruit and having a very important thing is enough of hours of sleep. You will learn also in this class how sleep is important. I know you probably heard that your parents were telling, oh, you need to sleep, but you will learn why. What's happening with the neurotransmitters in the body, and you will like realize, okay, I know my parents were right, but now I know why. So that's another thing that you will be, you know, learning in this class. Here, I would like a little bit mention about the rubric for your research paper. So it's really self-explanatory. As you can see in the beginning, when I have the rubric, I just did the, this part. And then on experience with the students, I realized, well, I have to put that, specify that step by step. So first, when you are preparing for the paper, please go through this section about, you know, learning the problem in public health and how you can solve that and what can be in the future. And then check this portion if everything is there, because you can see each of this is divided by steps. The topic for the research paper, you can pick up whatever topic you want. Maybe you were always interested, or maybe through the class you will learn like, oh, this topic is excellent, I would like to concentrate on that. And as you can see here, there are the five references, but only three needs to be scientific. The others can be whatever sources. Why I put there others from other sources? Because you need to get the motivation. Maybe you are just, you know, you went to Albertsons, you are waiting in front of the cashier, and you are bored, and you just check some of the magazines, and now you, well, think like, oh, I have that. And maybe that will be some article about Clean Water Act, or maybe article about antioxidants, or something on the global level. And you think like, oh, this is something that I would like to explore more. This is actually the problem in public health. So that's one of the references that will give you motivation. And based on this, you will develop the research paper. Also, there is the space that you can express your opinion and your thoughts. So please use that, because it's very important. You can see here at the end, because you know, you will be surprised that how students could be also innovative and having great ideas that maybe public health professionals, they don't have any clue, they are trying to find out how to solve some problem, and somehow it just clicks and you will get with that idea. So if there will be something, maybe you will be even writing and sending your research paper, you know, to the public health in Orange County department or to the government or something like that. You never know where your paper eventually can end up. So use your, you know, thoughts and your ideas. So this is the research paper. I'm not going much deeper into that because I know it's so still quite far. Before is the due for the research paper. I know there will be a lot of questions just 1 week before the submission. But start to observe now. Start to look around yourself, like what is connected with public health. Presentation. So it will be also the sign-up sheet that will be uploaded on the class website. If you know somebody already in this class and you realize, oh, I would like to work, you know, together on that topic, so please try to do this, because it's always good that you know somebody and you can, you know, to be like the partners through the group that you start to work on the topic. If not, there are the topics, I will show that to you, so based on the topic, on your interest, you can sign up yourself for that topic. So that will be uploaded probably tomorrow, so you can start, you know, to write your name there. When you will be working as a public health team together, also you are probably thinking, and I sometimes have the comments from students, they are telling me like, oh, we have 10 students in the public health team, it's so many, there should be presentation just for 2 people or 3 people. Well, I am trying to do the virtual community. I am trying to prepare you for the life as a professionals in public health. You will never ever have just 2 people or 3 people in public health team. 10 people is the small amount. Usually there will be 50 people or 100 people in the public health team. So this is something that you need to find out how to communicate, how to work together. You have probably, you will have also meeting after the class 1 or 2 times that you will see your you know, partners, public health partners in that team. You have to decide who will be like coordinator, who will be the leader, you know, who will be part or responsible for the specific sections in that specific topic in public health. So that's quite important. Why also I established the public health presentations? I know here in the classroom it's just the presentation, but imagine that you are working in public health team. Now suddenly your public health team of 10 people is called to go to Africa because there is the risk of exposure of hepatitis A, and they found out that the children are not vaccinated. And so you realize, okay, there is the specific window before there will be the symptoms of the disease. So during the incubation period of time, during the specific window, if we will do vaccination, there will be no symptoms, no disease among children. So now there are 10 people working in that. So imagine if some of them will miss, maybe will not bring the injection or some kind of, you know, delivery or something that it will be missed or not enough for that specific population. So what will happen? The children will get sick because the team didn't work the proper way as it should be working. Maybe not because there was not enough of, you know, supplies, but maybe the team was not working. You know, they were maybe calling like, oh, I just, you know, forgot, or I didn't have time or anything like that. So it's not possible. So I know here it's just the virtual community. It's just, you know, the points on your presentation. But I would like that you will feel close to your heart that part of this presentation is something that I'm learning for my future as a public health professional, that I will be responsible for that. And you will be really surprised. I got the feedback from the former students that they told me, wow, we are really trained for that. You know, and I can see that many of that other people in public health profession, they are not trained enough. Or sometimes they tell me that this public health team, they are learning in master degree or PhD level sometimes. So it's great that you will have the opportunity to learn that, you know, now. And I hope you will enjoy that, because, you know, then you will do the presentation, you will learn like team working together, support. So it's always fun. So I hope you will enjoy that, okay? So this is the rubric for presentation. Okay, so that's the group presentation. Here I also added information about, you know, your degree, so that I know that some of you are just coming. It's the first year for you as a public health major in public health policy or a public health science. So here is additional information that in case, of course, we have it on our public health website, but it's also connected with your syllabus. So this was the syllabus. I usually spent a lot of time the first class. Here are the topics. So please check also the topics that and find out that you are really interested in them. Some of them is about the healthcare system, public health service agencies, different countries that, you know, what is the public health, because it's also very important to compare how the public health works on the global level. What are the public health policies? Any of you can just name that you know what, just example of any public health policy. What could be public health policy? What
you can? No smoking within 20 feet of a building.
Yeah, excellent. Okay, other one. That's great. Okay, yeah. Which one? Yeah, okay. So other one. Yeah.
Like health inspectors and like restaurants.
Yeah, perfect. That we don't have, you know, frequently problem with E. coli or anything like that. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so I mean, it's amazing. I'm looking forward to be, you know, with this class together, because you are amazing. You already, you know many things that they are connected with public health policies. Basic one also, another one. How many of you are riding bicycle? Okay, are you wearing helmets? Yeah, no? So this is public health policy too, okay. And of course, everybody probably you have the seat belt when you are in the car, okay? This is the public health policy. Who is, I mean, when your classmate mentioned to go to the restaurant and check, who is checking that? Yes, public health professional. This checking the seat belts, it's public health policy, but who is checking that? Law enforcement. So it's the policeman, not public health. But, so there is also, you can see two different examples. Some of the public health policy is checked by public health professionals. Some of them are some other institution or some other that they are checking for that. What is healthy people? So some of you will be interested maybe to know about that. So you will find out there are the guidelines, it's the framework, how people should live and be healthy. And you will be quite surprised, like, and you can even do experiment and ask people if they know about that, because everything, all that recommendations are actually covered in that. So if you decide to be in group 1 to 5, or if you decide to be in the group 6 to 10, so you will have different topics about, you know, the outbreaks, the infectious diseases problems, different public health occupations. So maybe you will be using this group, will be using this textbook. And also achievements. Are you aware of any achievements in public health? You can just name that.
Antibiotics.
Yes, antibiotics. That was a really big change, yes. What else?
Polio vaccine.
Yes, that was amazing. Yeah, something else. You always think, I mean, it's great. You are thinking about the big things. But what about that you can, you know, how many of you think maybe when you go from this class, you will go to fountain and drink the water from the fountain? Maybe some of, yeah, Clean Water Act. I mean, this is amazing. You cannot do that in every country. So this is like, you know, you can see if you look around yourself. So just the basic things, yes, I can drink the water from the fountain. So that public health infrastructure was one of the achievements. It's still not on the global level. You can travel in some of the countries that it's not possible, but that's one of that also. So it's all eradication, you know, smallpox. So you can see there are many of different achievements. It's hard sometimes to tell which was more important than the other one. Sometimes you feel like, yes, antibiotics, it was very crucial. Vaccination, very crucial. But even the other are helping us, are improving the quality of life. So imagine how many of you have experience going to other countries that there was the water was not drinkable. And you have to all time, what did you do? Thinking all the time about bottle of the water? Yeah. So your mind, it's constantly, do I have the bottle of water, drinkable bottle of water with me? So you can see there is the quality of life is not very good because it's shift. There are shifts in that. You are thinking about that instead of something else. So we have to be aware of some components like that in public health. And future challenges, what do you think? I know, of course, you will learn that, therefore you are in this class to learn that. But what do you think, just from your idea, what could be challenges, future challenges in public health and on the global level? Any ideas? Anybody? Yeah?
Prevention medicine.
Yeah, preventative things. Because, you know, of course, healthcare system, it's going, you know, the financial part of that, it's going up so much. So is it possible that, you know, there will be access to everybody, but also doing the preventative things? So there is the combination of medical care system with public health, you know, system. That is another, and also maybe new diseases, how we will, what we will do about that, or resistance to antibiotics, that can be another challenge. So there are many different things as a challenges in the public health. So that will be on the group to find out. And oh, actually one more thing I wanted to show you. In case you will pick up any of that topics and you would like to little bit to do debate about that, so you can go a little bit lower and there are some additional questions. It's not that you are responding to the questions, but it can be helpful to each of the group that if any topic is connected with that, so you can use some of that portion and, you know, explain that. So there are the topics. This one, you see the road map for week 1 and 2. So I try a little bit to put that. It's not completely yet a study guide for the midterm or study guide for the final exam, but it's a little bit giving you idea what we will cover, some important links. Some of that links we will also go through them in the class, but it's just giving you a little bit idea. Also, the publisher, they have combination of the tests, so you can click on that and doing some kind of exercise on you know, on the tests. So here, supplemental resources for week 1 and 2. This is actually the chapters that I will be sharing with you. You have that in the PDF form. So that will be in case you would like to go faster through this and not accept PowerPoints. You can print that or use that. Okay, oh, this is this one actually. And this is like additional information. We will also go through that. Here is tips for the draft audios. I decided also because last year I have a little bit sometimes problems when I told students, yes, you are preparing for the presentation. Some students were thinking or somehow it took them too long to start to respond and to work on some of that topics they should do. So sometimes the leaders in that public health team, the groups, they were thinking that was not fair working with other students in the group. So I decided that each of the person, or if there are, they will be two of you working together. So this is just draft. It's just like to be sure that you are working, that everybody is doing the fair work. So whatever you prepare, even if it's not yet the final, you will just use. This is another thing that is very good, that you will be learning how to use YouTube or the audios. So you will, maybe two of you will be working on one topic. So you will do like just 3 minutes. Yes, this is our work, we prepare that. You will be not graded on that. It's just that you did that and you post it. So then you are getting like 1 or 2 points, because somehow it was hard for me to find out that there was the challenges. One was like the group leaders were telling, well, we didn't get anything from the student. And the student was telling, no, I was working on that. So that was the word against the word. So I decided, well, if there will be whatever, it can be PowerPoint or it can be just, you know, PDF form, and there will be like 2-3 minutes audio just to telling, yes, I did research and I did this and this part, and just post that. So it means, yes, we have that, and we just make the mark, it's there. So then it's possible to see that everybody was, you know, doing some kind of fair work. Plus, I'm thinking, well, maybe you can learn very soon to use, you know, to use the talk on the audio, so you will be not in a little bit higher level of the stress, like I may be at this moment when they do the camera. Actually, I lost the level of the stress. I'm okay. I'm fine. But, you know, it's something that if you learn that and you do that, that will be helpful to you. So this is this part. And here is Public Health Week's news. This is the thing that I would like also, and coming almost to the end of this class. I know it's usually the first meeting, me with students, it's like introductory in case you have questions or anything. So we will start mostly with the chapters, the next class. These are the links that I would like that also you go through that links and check that. You probably know this World Health Organization. We have two very important organizations. They are World Health Organization and PAHO also. It's Pan-American Health Organization. So they are trying and helping on the global level to keep some form of the public health infrastructure. American College of Lifestyle Medicine, you will have different topics there when you go through this website. A very important presentation will be there about sleep, how important sleep is, and what's happening if you don't have enough of hours of sleep. So this is something that I will be sharing with you next week. Exercise is medicine. Do you think it's true? Yeah. So this was the movement done through American College of Sports Medicine just probably 4 years ago. Now they have their own conference and now it's completely accepted that yes, exercise is medicine. But 4 years ago it just started. So people were thinking, oh, what are you talking about? Exercise as a medicine? Exercise is just the exercise. No. We learn that if people are doing the physical activity and any form of the exercise, they are improving their health and decreasing the risk of symptoms of chronic diseases. Another thing I always do with my students, I always let them go, and maybe some of you heard that from other classmates, maybe no, maybe not. I usually let always, because our class is until 10:50, I usually always let students to go 5 minutes earlier, but under one condition, okay? The condition is that during that 5 minutes, you will be doing something for your health. Because remember, this public health profession, I know you are laughing, okay, I will tell you what immediately. Because public health, you are still sitting, okay, we still have 2 minutes before that 5 minutes. So public health profession is very unusual in the way that you have to be the role model. You have to be involved, you have to feel like how, what is that being healthy? What is that, you know, what kind of barriers I can have that I am approaching, you know, my health behavior. So you are, you know, this is the profession, it's very unique. You cannot do that with other professionals, like how, for example, mathematicians. So how the mathematician could be, of course, role model about the knowledge about the math, mathematics, but you as a public health provider, as a, you know, doing this health modification. So 5 minutes, it means you will do what? You will do walking, breathing fresh air, checking all the trees and leaves and trying to make the connection, stress management, laughing, smile. I would like to see smile on all of your faces. Communicate with your classmate and think about antioxidant food for your lunch. Fruits, vegetables, grains and beans to see today on your plate. Under that condition, I am letting you go and see you next week, okay?